जबी भी जंग होती है तो दोनों तरफ के लोग मरते हैं और फिर यू नो देयर फैमिलीज आर विदाउट देयर सन्स विदाउट देयर फादर्स. जो ऑर्डर करते हैं जंग को उनको सामने खड़ा कर देना चाहिए कि ये लोग आए बंदूक के पकड़ो पहले आप लड़ो एक दिन के अंदर बंद हो जाएगा.
राजा तुझ में अपनी जान बसा दूं.
हेलो एवरीवन, गुड इवनिंग. व्हेन भाई प्रीचेस भाईचारा everyone sits up and listens. Salman Khan is the new peacenik in town and he rightly has today said that all war mongers should be sent to the border with a gun.
And who was he referring to, Shreya? Was he referring to some chest thumping anchors who in fact wage wars from television studios?
Or the TV warriors who are regularly their guests who every week want Pakistan and China to be bombed, possibly?
Yes, and was his advocacy of dialogue accidental, well thought out, or just a publicity stunt? Before we get into that, these are the headlines we are tracking this hour.
I think jo order karte hain jung ko unko samne khada kar dena chahiye ki ye log bhai bandook pakdo pehle aap lado ek din ke andar band ho jayega seedhe table ke upar aake jo bhi discussion hai wo ho jayega.
Salman Khan pitches for Indo-Pak peace, says dialogue is the only solution, slams war mongers ahead of his new film based on the 1962 war.
This peace pitch as the valley sees another video of Hezbollah militants roaming openly after 6 attacks on security personnel and camps last evening. The Lashkar meanwhile has put out a recruitment pitch asking Kashmiri youth to join them instead of joining the police or the army. They say anyone who joins in will be well compensated.
And the Ayush Ministry's Sanskari strike on pregnant women. No meat, no sex, pure thoughts only. Doctors say it's unscientific. Later, it issues a clarification, says it's been in place since the UPA. And our top story this evening, India's biggest star with a Twitter following of over a few millions and a regular presence in the 300 crore club has set a cat among the pigeons.
That's Salman Khan we are talking about. He has an equal fan base in India and Pakistan. Today he is advocating dialogue between the two countries. And not just that, he's also calling out war mongers we see every day in television studios and on Twitter, saying that all those who advocate war should be sent to the border with a gun. The actor was speaking at a promotional event of his latest film Tube Light that has the 62 Indochina war, I beg your pardon, as its backdrop.
जल्दी खत्म हो जाए ताकि हमारे जवान हमारे पास आ जाएं और उनके जवान उनके फैमिलीज के पास जल्दी से पहुँच जाएँ. जब भी जंग होती है तो दोनों तरफ के लोग मरते हैं और फिर यू नो देयर फैमिलीज आर विदाउट देयर सन्स विदाउट देयर फादर्स एंड देयर कुड लिव देयर होल लाइफ्स विदाउट देम. आई थिंक जो ऑर्डर करते हैं जंग को उनको सामने खड़ा कर देना चाहिए कि ये लोग आए बंदूकें पकड़ो पहले आप लड़ो एक दिन के अंदर बंद हो जाएगा पैर कांपने शुरू हो जाएंगे हाथ कांपने शुरू हो जाएंगे और सीधे टेबल के ऊपर आके जो भी डिस्कशन है वो हो जाएंगे.
And speaking to CNN News 18, Salman Khan's father, Salim Khan, backed his son's statement, saying war was not a sensible thing. Listen in.
Well, who do you think he's referring to? And how do you react? It's your son we are talking about. How do you react to this?
इसके ऊपर तीन चार दिन तक बात कर सकते हैं. Every time a war happened, when you look back, it was ridiculous and avoidable. That's all. ये चर्चिल की लाइन है. दूसरी लाइन है एक रशियन पोएट की. Every time a bullet fired in war, it reaches its target, it reaches the mother's heart. War, in any case, is not the solution to anything. Everybody knows that. Why when such a issue is being raised?
Bhai preaching bhaichara ahead of his new film. What he has said is what I would feel that any sensible Indian would say. But has his peace pitch crossed all boundaries, or has it held a mirror to the hyper-nationalist TV warriors we see every evening on our television screens? I'm putting that question to Zafar Sareshwala, who's a close friend of the Khan Khandan. Major Tanul Singhal is joining us on the story as well. He's in the studio, and I'm also being joined by Gohar Gulani. We will be joined by Gohar Gulani in just a bit from Srinagar. Zafar, I'm coming to you first. Who exactly is Salman Khan referring to when he says that all those who advocate war should be sent marching to the border?
See, actually, what Salman has said, this articulates his personality. You know, he's a man of compassion. You know, he treats every day. If you come and see Bandra Bandstand, at least 100 people are there every day. He signs checks worth 8-9 lakhs of rupees. He is very sensitive to people's sufferings. He's gone to the border, you must have seen earlier. He's always, this is reflection of Salman Khan's personality.
But you know, we have not seen him being political before. Mr. Zafarwala, we have not seen him being political before. Yes, we did see that picture of him flying the kite with Prime Minister Modi when he was not the Prime Minister. But apart from that, Salman Khan has been fairly non-political, like most of Bollywood. Why suddenly come out with this peace pitch? Is it because there's a film that is releasing, and a film that is to be released not just in India but Pakistan as well?
No, I think, I mean, this would be very far-fetched, because I don't think, I mean, what Salman Khan is, Salman Khan doesn't need any publicity. And, you know that films don't work on these kind of things. Film has to have content. And story, these are the issues which work for a film.
But I mean, Sareshwala,
if at all anybody uses this as a publicity,
but Mr.
it doesn't
Sareshwala,
work. And Salman doesn't need it at all.
Absolutely.
And Salman is apolitical. I mean, this is a very normal statement which he has made. And yes, and I would also advocate this, lot of people in this country are jingoistic. I mean, the armchair critics who sit there and they talk of war and everything, they don't want to go. And I would have also say the same thing. भाई इतना शौक है लड़ने का तो आप जाइए एंड दिस इज एग्जैक्टली व्हाट आवर गवर्नमेंट इज आल्सो डूइंग वी आर डूइंग एग्जैक्टली एवरीथिंग अदर देन द वॉर
Sir,
I mean, we are using the diplomatic channel.
Mr. Sareshwala,
we are using
timing.
Every single forum available. The Prime Minister goes wherever he goes.
Mr. Sareshwala,
he
you know, sometimes one feels
isolating Pakistan.
Mr. Sareshwala, sometimes. Mr. Sareshwala,
other than war issues,
sometimes one feels that the real world, Salman Khan's world, the Bollywood, is perhaps disconnected with the real world. If you look at the kind of ceasefire violations that are going on, if you look at what the Indian Army is facing at the border, six attacks on security personnel, 3 ceasefire violations, 13 CRPF personnel injured, and here it is someone who is a superstar. He's a superstar who impacts lives of millions. His words carry weight, and for him to talk about it at this time, is it right?
No, I'll take a larger context of it. I mean, even in spite of this, are we talking of war? I mean, surgical strike, targeting those, you know, the targeted attacks, they're okay. Salman is talking about war. And our government, our army also doesn't want a war.
Okay,
yes. We don't want war.
Let's.
This is exactly the line we have taken.
Okay.
We are using every available forum to isolate Pakistan.
Mr. Zafar Sareshwala.
The FCO.
Mr. Zafar Sareshwala.
In presence of Nawaz Sharif, Mr. Modi made a very bold speech. So these are the issues which should be dealt other than war.
Major okay. Tanul Singhal, let's get him now.
Let's get the army view.
Yes.
Wars have been unnecessary, ridiculous, and if you take in hindsight, they have not done anything
okay.
to anybody.
Okay, Mr.
So
okay.
other than war,
sir,
we have
okay.
lot of other things we should
Mr. Sareshwala, you've made your point. Let's just get a voice from the Indian Army. Major Singhal, thank you very much for being in the
Pleasure.
Studio. What do you make of Salman Khan's statement? To an Indian like me, I would say, sahi to bola, kya galat bola? Hyper-jingoism is going on in this country.
So I'll put
you know, anyone who's a peacenik is almost a gali. If you call someone a peacenik, someone who's advocating peace, he's anti-national or she's anti-national. This is the mahal in this country.
Yeah.
Many people would say what Salman Khan has said is sensible. It is what any sensible Indian would say. Any sensible Indian who has family,
so
at
let
least
me,
in
let
the
me
army.
Answer you. I've understood. So basically, you know, please treat Salman's view on this subject as a layman's perspective. You know, it's nothing beyond, because for him as a person, a layman, to understand war and peace, what's happening in Kashmir, what's happening on China border, what's happening otherwise, it's very difficult for a layman. But he was talking on his film promotion, you know, that was about to release. Just treat him like a statement made in the wake of a film made on 1962 war.
Certainly,
wherein few people, few Indians, many Indians I would say, have lost their lives. So he must have interacted from that perspective, his emotions must have given that thought. But having said that, you know, I'm not saying war is the only solution or the peace is the only solution. There are other expressions of instrument, you know, instrument of expression, wherein you can actually be a, you know, deal with Pakistan, which is a rogue nation, that's for very sure, which is a confused nation with an iron fist hand. And that's what I think the present government, the current government has started doing it. While they are dealing with Hurriyat, while they are dealing with separatists, they're weeding them out of all the money that they're having.
You know, I'm going to go back to Zafar Sareshwala. Zafar Sareshwala, Salman Khan is not new to controversies. And the kind of statements that he has made in recent times, that Pakistani artists are not terrorists, I think it's a valid statement to say. Om Puri has said that Pakistani artists come here on visa, not illegally. But you know, sir, for Salman Khan to say, and what Major Tanul Singhal is saying, that he said it as a layman. Can he really qualify as a layman?
No, I mean, I would not call Salman Khan is certainly not a layman. I mean, he's a superstar. He has a long history, a career in films. He's seen the world. He's been to the border. He's seen the lives of the army jawans. He's taking care of hundreds of people. But I agree with Major Singhal that yes, and he's also saying the same thing. War or peace is not the, we have so many other options, avenues. So Salman has a normal, any sane person, which you said, normally, main aur aap kya kahenge? Nahin bhai.
नहीं वो तो ठीक है, बिल्कुल जफर सरेशवाला, जफर सरेशवाला बिल्कुल, वो तो मैं बोल ही रही हूँ कि एनी सेंसिबल इंडियन वुड हैव सेड व्हाट सलमान खान इज सेइंग. व्हाट एवरीवन इज क्वेश्चनिंग आई थिंक इज द टाइमिंग. यू नो देयर इज अ बिग फिल्म दैट इज सेट टू रिलीज, इट विल रिलीज नॉट जस्ट इन इंडिया, इट विल रिलीज इन पाकिस्तान एज वेल. सो दिस इज द टाइम टू मेक बोथ साइड्स हैप्पी, दैट देयर इज नथिंग लाइक अ गुड कॉन्ट्रोवर्सी टू किक स्टार्ट अ फिल्म.
नहीं, आई सी, दिस फिल्म इज अबाउट वॉर.
Correct.
And this was the question asked to him. This film is in the backdrop of China war. And the atmosphere, that is a coincidence.
You know, it's
so
also,
somebody,
sir,
asked this question on basis of that. And you very rightly pointed out earlier, ke hamare raat ke 9 baje kya ho raha hai? Bahut sare television channels par.
Right.
So, wo bhi ta ek reflection
hai,
that's also happening.
But you know, so the statement is also hypocritical, because Salman Khan in the film industry is known to not work with anybody who has caused him or his family some harm. And perhaps he is readily forgetting that principle.
But then see, the other side of Salman Khan, we all know. Every single day you come.
But what about this side of Salman Khan?
Bandra residence.
But what about this
Salman
side
Khan,
of Salman
he helps.
Yeah,
no,
but
I
it
think
is
that is Salman Khan doesn't need to work with anybody.
No,
I mean,
no.
He,
so
he has his own
that's not
strength in the film industry.
What Marya was asking, I think, was in context of what happened with Arijit Singh, the singer,
yes.
Right? Mr. Zafar Sareshwala, we know how that played out. You have a minor fight or a disagreement with someone. You ensure that the entire film industry boycotts him. And then here you are saying that, you know, there is tension between India and Pakistan. Oh, but let's talk. Good to get an army view in. I want to ask you this. You know, Zafar Sareshwala is making the point that there are jingoistic armchair warriors every evening in television studios beaming into our homes. There have been editorials written about how the mob has entered not just our psyche, but our homes as well. I want to ask you, does for the army, is that the bigger disservice, and is that what Salman Khan is calling out to, showing a mirror to this you know, crazy jingoism we have seen in the last 6, 8, 10 months.
Yeah, so believe Zafar Saab has a point in there. You know, there are a lot of mouth warriors these days who are doing the show saying, you know, we should go for a war. War is not
bomb
something.
Bomb Pakistan, bomb China. Do to maine sune hain.
So, you know, war is not that easy a game. You know, you just click a thing that we need to plan a trip to Europe and that's on, we are on the plane and go. No. So war is played through various channels and we are living in a fifth generation of warfare. State versus state warfare is something that we should not look for, you know, unless until upon forced upon, which may be the case, you know, Pakistan.
As an ex-army man, would you ever want you're now retired, but would you ever want your colleagues to go into a full proper law? Many people can say, "Ab Kashmir mein jo chal raha hai, that is war only, na? It's not war, it's not peace. It's somewhere in the middle." But would you want a full-fledged war as an army person? I would think that, you know, the true cost of war is only a soldier knows or his family knows.
So I'll tell, you know, as an army man, if you would ask, no army man would want a war. But if coming to us, I'll tell each army man, each army officer, each army jawan is ready for war. And India can actually reiterate in a manner that is befitting for a Pakistan army and its leadership to know that India is game for it. But yes, if you ask to go for a war as an initiative, as a first step, as a first move, I don't think India will ever do it.
Okay.
Yes, and Shreya, you know, all this, because we are talking about the timing, let's put this in context. Because this peace talk is coming as Pakistan continues to provoke India at a time when there have been 6 attacks on security personnel and 3 ceasefire violations, 13 CRPF personnel injured. The attacks, 5 in South and 1 in North Kashmir, came in a span of 4 hours.
Okay, now let us show you a new Lashkar video that is making a recruitment pitch to young people in the Kashmir Valley. You'll just see that video in just a bit. It has an LET commander, Abu Uksha, urging Kashmir's young people not to join security forces, say the army or the police. He's telling them, join us instead, join the LET instead and fight for the Azadi. And if money is an issue, he says, just come to us. Money is not an issue with us. So essentially saying, you know, telling us two things. A, that they are open for recruitment, and B, that money is not an issue with terror organizations like the LET. Just listen in to that video.
اللہ تعالیٰ فرماتا ہے اے ایمان والو تم مومنوں کو چھوڑ کر کافروں کو اپنا دوست نہ بناؤ اے میرے کشمیر کے بھائیو بہنوں بزرگو آج تمہارے لیے دو راستے کھلے ہیں ایک راستہ ہے مومنوں کا مجاہدین کا حریت پسندوں کا مسلمانوں کا مظلوموں کا دوسرا راستہ ہے کافروں کا منافقین کا غداروں کا اور کافروں کفار کے اعلیٰ کاروں کا ظالموں کا تمہیں آج یہ فیصلہ کرنا ہوگا تم کس کے ساتھ ہو اے کشمیری پولیس والو تم کیوں اپنی بھائیوں سے لڑ کر مودی کو خوش کرنا چاہتے ہو چند ہزار کے لیے کیوں اپنے خالق و مالک کو ناراض کرنا چاہتے ہو تمہارا جینا مرنا تو ہمارے ساتھ ہے پھر ہم سے یہ دشمنی کیوں یا یہ کون سی عقل مندی ہے کہ تم سٹار اور پروموشن کے لیے اپنا دین اور آخرت بیچ ڈالو اپیل ہے کہ آؤ تم بھی کلمہ پڑھنے والے ہم بھی کلمہ پڑھنے والے ہم مل کر ہندوستان سامراج کے خلاف ایک صف بن جائیں کیا تمہیں اللہ سے ڈر نہیں لگتا آؤ اگر تمہیں پیسہ ضرورت ہے تو ہم دیتے ہیں تو ہندوستان فوج کے خلاف لڑو ہم تمہیں بھرپور انعام دیں گے
It has almost become a trend for terrorists in Kashmir to not hide their identity anymore. Continuing with the disturbing trend that started with Burhan Wani, terrorists from Hizbul Mujahideen and Lashkar-e-Taiba have released a video of them strolling and training in South Kashmir. This is an open provocation to security forces where they are saying, you know who we are, now come and join us.
I'm going to take a question to Major Tanul. Major Tanul, this is the backdrop in which Salman Khan's statement has come.
Yeah.
There's the LET, there's the Lashkar, which is openly recruiting, saying we have enough money, guys. If you want money and if you want employment, we are the people to come to. Don't go to army recruitment camps or CRPF recruitment camps. Then we have the Hizbul. Purane zamane mein, we used to see their faces covered and that's how they would pose with their guns. Now, all of that has gone out of the window. These guys have no qualms about parading themselves, showing their faces, brandishing guns. In fact, in this particular video, if you look closely, Major Tanul, they are even wearing their nameplates. So they are telling security forces, we are here. You know exactly who we are. Come get us. So this is open provocation. So Salman Khan's statement is coming in this context. Is that why there's so much debate about it?
So I will answer it in two parts. So one, if you would recall, Burhan Wani leading the pack of 13 odd people doing all the social media. That one odd
that one picture. Yeah,
very important one. So if you would recall and if you would know, so out of those 13, one is alive.
Correct.
You know, 10 have been given the place that they deserve. One is untraceable. So almost 13 are, you know, almost have shown the door. Now coming on to this video, which has been which has just been displayed. This is an actually a, I would say, reaction to the people of JNK now going for the recruitment camps of army, CRPF, other paramilitary forces, and also
thousands have turned up.
And also, if you would recall, there is a recently a IMA, you know, passing out parade wherein 11 people from that region,
from Kashmir,
have passed out. So this is more so that trend which is going in the favor for the armed forces, for the positivity, for all these years that they've displayed in the valley, is actually coming and reaping the good gains, you know. So times to come, in few months, this gentleman will also be shown the, you know, shown the way to heaven, and he will be given his due.
Let me get Zafar Sarishwala on this. Zafar Sarishwala, there is a sentiment in this country at present, because what we showed right now, the kind of video that is being released by various terror groups, and you know, if Salman Khan has to be political, then shouldn't he be political like a Meryl Streep? Make an open pitch.
Marya, and you know this video is basic. It shows sign of desperation.
Correct.
And I would articulate what Singhal Saab said. See, these are very minority of minority. I mean,
that's
Burhan
right.
Wani, you only said he had 10 or 11 people. Now you see a parallel narrative. The army, that's what I'm coming to the point. Army is fighting insurgency and everything. You know what army does? Army is running one of the best, several schools. They are running UPSC training centers. This year, 14 Kashmiri boys and girls got selected in UPSC.
Correct.
A guy from Kashmir was in first 10.
Correct.
They are also parallel running the joint entrance IIT exam where 9 Kashmiri students got selected. The CRP, police, paramilitary training.
So
thousands of Kashmiris have come. So actually this is a slap to these people, the Lashkar-e-Tayyaba people and of his like.
Zafar Sarishwala.
So this is a sign of desperation.
Got it. Absolutely
so
right.
Parallel
that's
to
correct,
all this.
That's a correct
the Kashmiri,
interpretation.
The Indian army is doing yeoman service. So not only war.
Maybe Salman
they
Khan.
They are taking care of that,
Mrs.
the border. And
can go to the border.
Mr.
Sarishwala, maybe Salman Khan could have done a yeoman service for Kashmir by saying, instead of saying what he did, what he said was absolutely fine as well, but he could have even added that all young people in the Kashmir Valley, please don't pick up guns against the Indian state. Terrorists are trying to brainwash you. Please stay away from violence and stone pelting. Maybe Salman Khan should have spoken about that as well. I mean, you know, if he can talk about marching people to the border with guns, he could have probably spoken about this as well. It's high time, you know, that our film stars became a little political
and spoke open about it.
And spoke about issues of the day.
No, you'll be, you have, I think, missed a very important point. Salman Khan's earlier film, Bajrangi Bhaijaan, it was extensively shot in Kashmir.
Exactly.
And Salman was there with the crew for more than 60 days.
Correct.
And he did lot of positive things then in Kashmir. People are even remembering now. And I am going to use his popularity in setting up a school in Srinagar under the auspices of Maulana Azad National Urdu
but
University.
But before that, why don't you ask him, why don't you ask him to tell young people in Kashmir, of course, but another great initiative would be, Zafar Sareshwala, since you know him so well, is to openly come out and tell young people in Kashmir not to pick up the gun against the Indian state and to stop stone pelting. He has a huge fan base, both in India and in Pakistan. We know he's a huge star. We know he's much loved in Kashmir as he is in the rest of the country. Why doesn't he come out with a simple statement like that? That would be more helpful than saying that, you know, let people march to the border if they want war.
Yeah, I mean, I'll convey this to Salman and he will do it. I mean, yes, people in Kashmir love him.
Yes.
Even in Pakistan.
Hmm.
So, his essential, you see the films which he has made, Bajrangi Bhaijaan, you know, he talks of unity, peace. That is reflection of Salman Khan's personality.
Okay.
So, oh, perhaps was it wrongly interpreted? Perhaps you can say that too, Zafar Saab.
Yeah, I mean, it was wrongly interpreted. I mean, and I would also say the same thing with somebody else other than the Khan would have said, it wouldn't have become a story today.
Oh, only because he is a Khan.
Oh. Well, I would completely agree with that. Zafar Sareshwala, I know it's time for iftar, so we'll let you go. Thank you very much for joining us this evening. Major Singhal, thank you very much for being with us in the studio. It was good to have you. Thank you very much.
You know, Shreya, the question is also about Bollywood stars' selective outrage.
Why? You know, this wasn't outrage, Marya.
You know,
I mean, this wouldn't qualify as outrage. But yeah, if you need, I do think that it's time that like Hollywood, it's time for Bollywood stars
absolutely
to also come out and tell us what their political leanings are.
And also not be judged in terms of binaries of right and wrong.
Hmm.
There is also limitation that is happening in the way statements are being looked at.
Hmm.
Jingoism is the new.
And as I said, being
word.
A peacenik is a bad word in the times we live in. All right. With that, we are slipping into a quick break on the show. Coming up next, well, a sanskari strike, Marya, on pregnant women, courtesy the Ayush Ministry. They are advising all pregnant women to keep away from meat and sex. Now there's a clarification that has come in as well. We are talking about all of that in just a bit. Do stay with us. Welcome back. The Ayush Ministry, that is responsible for the spread of Ayurveda and yoga, now has a piece of advice for pregnant women, and this is a sanskari strike.
Yes, clearly. What have they said is, don't eat meat, say no to sex after conception, avoid bad company, have spiritual thoughts and hang good and beautiful pictures in your room to have a healthy baby. The recommendations are part of a booklet called Mother and Child Care, released by the Ayush Ministry in the run-up to the International Yoga Day on June 21st. Now, the ministry has issued a clarification that it was issued during the UPA in 2013 and that it's not a recent one. Joining us now, Manju Gupta is a senior consultant in the Department of Gynecology at the JP Hospital. Thanks so much for your time here. And Rahul Ishwar is an activist as well. Rahul, I'm coming to you. India's maternal mortality rate is a matter of concern. Around 44,000 women die of pregnancy-related causes in India each year. And the minister and the ministry believes in talking about avoiding sex and good thought. What is this grandmother attitude? Dadi maa bolti hai ye sab.
This is not grandmother attitude. This is a parent state attitude in political parlance.
Parent
and please
state.
Remember, what is Central Council for Research in Yoga and Naturopathy saying?
They you should talk about yoga.
Pregnant women and stay away from desire, anger,
what?
Hatred.
Why
love.
Desire?
And please remember, this is part and parcel of yoga. This is part and parcel of yoga and naturopathy for thousands of years.
Hmm.
Please remember, every text has a context and a subtext. You are unnecessarily, you know, removing the paradigm and context.
No.
This is from a yoga paradigm and this is a practice which is accepted worldwide.
Rahul,
only in India.
Rahul Ishwar, does the ministry, Ayush ministry, have nothing better to do? What is the big problem in India with pregnant women? Anemia. Has the Ayush ministry issued a research on that or said anything about that? No, they haven't. A big concern is babies who are born underweight. That is a big concern in India. Has the Ayush ministry said anything about that? No. But they are saying don't have sex, only have good thoughts. don't eat meat. Are if they don't eat meat, where will the nutrition, the
protein,
where will protein come from? It's nonsensical to...
There are millions of vegetarians in this nation. Do you think they are all having protein deficiency? One. Second, please, what is the...
Manju Gupta, respond.
I'll quote the exact one. Mother and child care through yoga...
Mr. Rahul, listen to me. We are not asking them...
You are confusing it with an allopathic...
No. We are not asking them to make a choice.
Mother and child care through yoga and Ayurveda. Yoga and naturopathy.
Rahul, if you restrict...
taking it out of context.
Rahul,
if you restrict yourself to yoga, we will be very happy. Yoga and naturopathy is very good, but asking a woman not to have meat, that is something which is not, that is not right. Why should, you are talking about vegetarians not having protein deficiency, that's absolutely true. But if a lady is having meat, what's wrong in it? If she is having her nutrition through meat or then, through chicken or through, then what is wrong in it? Why are you saying not
question.
To have? What
I
is
have,
wrong in having
I
meat?
I have another question.
You tell us that. Man, what is wrong in having
scientific basis?
There is no scientific basis in not having
Ayurveda,
meat.
Ayurveda, yoga, Unani, naturopathy. This is Ayush ministry. And
but
there
no, Ayush ministry should restrict to the herbal remedies, to their naturopathy, to their yoga. But what is the harm in having meat, having sex? What is the harm? You tell us the harm of having meat. Or harm of having sex. You tell
Please
us the
remember,
single
the
disadvantage of having sex.
The word is lust, greed, anger, attachment.
So what does that mean? So what does desire and lust mean?
The whole controversy would be meaningful.
What does desire and lust mean?
That's
not
what does
ministry.
What does desire and lust mean? It means sex only. Just a minute, Rahul Ishwar. I now want to get one quick question that I'm sure a lot of women who are seeing this needless debate play out want to ask. Is there any scientific basis in what the Ayush ministry is saying that you should not have lust, desire / sex when you're pregnant?
No, nothing like that. In fact, many of the pregnant women feel very left out. If they are asked for, some husbands are like that, they are very skeptical and they ask their, they refrain from sex in those 9 months. And the women come to us and they feel very low, they feel very left out. If they are not, because yes, obviously you are a woman and for 9 months having no sex is sometimes difficult for them. So we cannot ask them not to have sex for 9 months. Why? There is no scientific reason for it. For first 12 weeks, yes, definitely we do advise, and for later on in some cases. But generalized, a blanket statement of not having sex is just not justified. Absolutely wrong. And even they may not be knowing what is the harm. Ask them the harm. There is no harm. Sex does not mean a desire and lust. It doesn't. Sex is a natural phenomenon which is very much required.
You know, but this thing what the Ayush ministry has said, to put up big pictures of healthy babies,
see,
does it really impact mind?
No, it is just that you should have a good, you should always have good thoughts. And especially when you are pregnant, then the positive vibes come from positive things. So just good pictures, scientifically even they don't play a role. But we do ask women that if you are in depression, definitely that gonna affect her baby. So you should be happy, you should do whatever you feel like. And if, things to such an extent that it should not harm you. But if you feel
you
like
know, Rahul
sex,
Ishwar,
it's okay.
Rahul Ishwar, you know, Ayurveda is a positive thing. It's a alternative medicine which is positive. Then, you know, with this kind of advisory that is issued, are you not in some way denigrating a medicine which has also proved to be beneficial in the past? You know, because what the doctor is saying that it has nothing to do with sex.
100 years back when the British
avoiding
people were
sex.
Ruling, they used to denigrate Ayurveda and yoga. Now, world over, Ayurveda and yoga are accepted. And you can see the International Yoga Day, yoga being embraced by even European nations.
Like
so, these are systems and templates of yoga. And please see this in the context of yoga. The whole controversy would be meaningful had health ministry given these guidelines. And these are only guidelines by Ayush ministry. And Ayush ministry
no,
is
avoid
bad
companies saying,
yoga,
saying
Ayurveda,
that these
Sankara,
are just guidelines.
These kind of things are the templates on which Ayush ministry
saying
works.
Just that these are guidelines, you're letting the Ayush ministry, you know, go scot-free on this one. I'm sure the Ayush ministry has a lot of better things to do than to tell women not to eat meat and not to have sex when they are pregnant. For example, as I said, has the Ayush ministry spoken about nutritional health for women? No, they haven't. Have they spoken about anemia? No, they haven't. Have they spoken about, the weight of children when they are born? No, they haven't. Doctor, go ahead. What do you make of this guideline as they are calling it by the Ayush ministry?
As I talked earlier also, guideline is a heavy word. You cannot say just the guidelines. Moreover, there are many things. If you say something, you should have a proper evidence for it. What is the harm of having sex? You tell me that. If you are saying we are absolutely okay with yoga, with naturopathy, with herbal remedies, but there is no question, there is no scientific evidence behind having no sex, there is no scientific evidence having against beautiful paintings about not having desire. How can you tell a woman not to have a desire in pregnant mode? I mean, this is
Rahul Ishwar, I saw you raising your hand. You want something? You have something to say?
And clarified. The booklet does not contain any advice on abstaining from sex. Please remember
what
the
does no desire and no lust means.
Not sex.
What does no desire and no lust mean?
Yoga, naturopathy is having a totally different connotation.
No, what does no desire and no lust mean?
But attachment in the context of yoga and naturopathy
no,
are different.
So you
are unnecessarily missing the template and paradigm and using the words in another context.
No, it says
yoga, yama, niyamas, and all the things.
See what
Rahul is saying. Pregnant women should detach themselves from desire, anger, attachment, hatred and lust, avoid bad company, be with good people. This is what it says.
What do you mean that a pregnant lady should be deported to some place where she is there along the plants and the good paintings and she should not be with her husband? She should not have all that desire. That is what you mean to say. Avoid bad company. She should live with saints. She should
that's
live with saints, spinsters, and
that's what
that
it
is
says.
What yoga has to say, what Unani has to say.
Overstress these guidelines.
No, you cannot. You don't have any justification. You don't have any evidence.
The clarification, you know, Rahul, the clarification that has just come from the Ayush Ministry is that this has been in place in the UPA, so it should not be seen as recent guidelines. But why not revisit the guidelines? Why just keep
issuing it? It should have been read again.
Correct. Rahul, you want to come in on that?
Are these guidelines not scientific according to the paradigms of yoga and naturopathy? Is English medicine and allopathy the only yardstick for giving a pregnant mother
that is
any
not,
care and
that is not anyone.
You are
that is
only
not anyone's
the whole
contention.
Base from base of allopathy.
That
is
not
no
anyone's
mode
contention.
Of medicine,
is
no mode of medicine.
That is not anyone's contention.
During pregnancy.
Yoga is a totally different system.
Everyone knows the benefits of yoga. Everyone knows the benefits of Ayurveda. Sometimes I trust Ayurveda more than I trust allopathy. But having said that, I'm saying, does the Ayush Ministry have nothing better to do? Don't they have more important things to do than to issue stupid guidelines?
Ayush Ministry cannot go on building roads. Ayush Ministry cannot go on building ports and airports.
No,
that is not what anyone is saying. Health of people.
That, of course, and health just doesn't mean pregnant women not having sex. That is exactly the point I'm getting to. Doctor, you wanted to say something.
I'm saying there are no ways that you have written how you can improve nutrition. There is no way how you can improve the birth weight. What you have talking about is not to have sex, not to have desire. How will that improve the birth weight of the baby, which is again a low birth weight, which is again quite prevalent in India? How will you improve the nutritional status? Not having sex will improve the nutritional status of a mother? Tell me.
Respond, Rahul Ishwar.
Rahul Ishwar, respond
is
to the doctor.
Is there a statement called don't have sex in it? Is there some statement called
not having desire, not having lust? I'll go by your words. Not to have desire, not to have lust. How will that improve the nutritional status of a mother, or how will that improve the how will that reduce the morbidity in mother or a baby? You tell me that.
That will improve the mental stature of a particular woman
mental
or the mother.
Mental stature will not be improved by not having lust. She will feel more left out.
And then those
sex
beautiful pictures will
life.
Be of no good.
You please understand that. You cannot refrain anyone from having sex. And no medicine says that.
The minister himself clarified. Please don't overstress
arguments. It's written in the booklet.
Rahul
Ishwar, he can clarify till the cows come home, but it's written in the booklet. No desire and no lust.
And Ayush Minister went on record to clarify.
Yes, Rahul Ishwar, the Ayush Minister has gone on to clarify. But what is written in the booklet is written in the booklet. We cannot deny that has been written. It has been republished and distributed ahead of Yoga Day. It is something we cannot deny either, can we?
Exactly.
So should the government accept, should the Ayush Ministry accept its stupidity and say, all right, now we are withdrawing these guidelines and we'll come up with something more sensible?
They should.
See, this is not stupid. These are the templates and systems in which yoga is being practiced. There are many yamas and niyamas in yoga. And according to yoga and yogic systems, when a mother is being pregnant, there are certain things that a mother should do. You
and
can
become
definitely
a grandmother.
Take it or leave it. But according to yoga, these are the templates. And
so,
please remember, this is
so the
only
ministry
for
should become a grandmother.
Who believe and practice yoga and naturopathy.
No, so the ministry should become a grandmother and talk about avoiding tea, coffee, sugar is all right. But to also say, not limiting it to the food habits, but essentially going ahead and talking about also issuing advisory, talking about detaching themselves from desire, anger, hatred, attachment, lust, even good company. Perhaps good
and
only
remember,
and limit to good company. Limit yourself
how to decide what is good and what is bad company.
Yes, good company and bad company.
What do you mean by bad company?
Define good company and bad company.
It's used in a different context altogether.
Ayush Ministry should have also defined good company
and
bad
company.
Okay. Okay.
Exactly. She should keep good company. She should have positive things.
How do you define
good
that?
Picture, which only means the whole
clearly, her husband's company is not good
yes.
company.
It's the wrong thing to say.
You know, Rahul, we refrained and she reported to Vrindavan for 9 months.
Rahul, clearly a husband's company is not good company.
And
according
good,
to
you
the
know,
Ayush
she should not be partying.
She
should
not be partying. She should be deported to Vrindavan and Mathura. For whole 9 months,
really?
So that she
and reality what the Ayush Ministry needs is a reality check. Doctor, thank you very much for joining us. Rahul, Ishwar, thank you very much for joining us on the debate. It was good to have you on the show.
In fact, the ministry has issued a clarification, and in fact, they are repeating what has been said since the 2013.
If 2013, a mistake was made. It doesn't
Why not
mean
correct
that you. It doesn't mean you repeat it in 2017.
On that note, we are slipping into a short break. Coming up, entire building gutted. While fatality is confirmed in the massive fire breakout in West London, residential tower. We'll get you details when we return. Stay with us.
Welcome back. This is breaking news that is just coming in. Five ISI agents have been arrested near Jaisalmer. In fact, two of them have been arrested near the airbase in Jaisalmer, which is the Bari Marya.
Yes, and so there has been certain recovery as well. A mobile phone has been recovered with military pictures and SIM cards of Pakistan as well. Apprehensions close to border where Pakistan signal spills over.
So this is the big worry that is coming in. There was a spy racket that was busted last year, and now we have five ISI agents who have been arrested near Jaisalmer. This is the piece of breaking news we are tracking. For the moment, the details that are available are sketchy. We'll try and get you more as we get it. Moving on to some international news now. A 27-story tower in London caught fire today. The blaze raged on for hours. At least six people are now dead.
Several people were trapped in the fire in the Greenfell Tower in West London's Notting Hill. More than 200 firefighters were trying to douse the fire that had engulfed every floor from the 2nd to the 27th. Witnesses saw people stuck in their apartments and were unable to leave. The cause of the fire is still unknown.
I came here first. I couldn't really get a good picture of the fire, so I moved over to a little bit further up on Lancaster Road, and it was the whole building was engulfed in fire. It was a ball of fire.
Right now, it's just very traumatic, and people are trying to find missing family members
right.
that they've lost or blaming themselves.
Right.
You know, and it's not they're not to blame. It's the council and everybody else that's responsible for, you know, not putting safety measures in place.
As far as I'm concerned, if this was a town hall on fire, it would have been put out a long time ago, and it'd be water falling from the sky from whatever vehicle they had to bring to put that fire out. But down here in North Kensington, it appears our lives are expendable as usual.
At least six people, in fact, died in that fire, Shreya. A 27-story tower in London that caught fire.
With that, it's a wrap from Marya and me. Arundhay Mukherjee is up next. Thanks for watching. Good night.